Damn! Mutated fungi, infected creatures, and a whole lot of, confrontations.
I don't like confrontations!
Today, we are reacting to and breaking down the wild medical scenes and injuries from the action-adventure game, The Last of Us. Prepare yourselves, because it's about to get real post-apocalyptic up in here. Let's dive right in.
They're behind me, too!
There!
Hold on! Go!
Oh. Did you just run over somebody? If that occurs, we think about it as a major trauma and you're worried about fractures, internal organs that have been just demolished. If you get run over, you're worried about crush injuries.
She went under the wheels.
Oh, damn! Was not wearing seatbelt, got tossed to the other side. There's a lot of damages that can occur. We get people who get brain bleeds, skull fractures, missing limbs. It's been proven that seatbelts save lives and people still don't use them. So please wear your seatbelt. Those wires, depending on the amps, there's a high chance of tissue destruction, muscle breakdown, it can cause your heart to stop. Hopefully somebody gets there quickly on scene that can then use energy again to then try to restart your heart. Oh, no. Oh man, people getting infected with a fungus. There are a lot of different fungal infections out there, but we're limited by how we can treat them. It is a big burden worldwide, but we have a few antifungal medications out there that may help.
Let's get out of here before this fungus beats us alive.
Sweet, a health kit. I'm not sure what's in this health kit, but if you have one at your house, you should have like basic stuff. Band-aids, gauze, maybe some antibiotic ointment or steroid ointment. Medications wise, acetaminophen, ibuprofen, and probably diphenhydramine, which is Benadryl. All right, crouch it down, put the health kit on. There we go, we got wrapping the forearm. Really cool integration of healing techniques in a video game. You actually have to take time out of what you're doing to then use it. Actually really good, because it's more realistic. Oh! What is happening? You can cause somebody to pass out pretty easily by decreasing blood flow to the brain real fast, compressing down on the carotid arteries. Just be aware, even if you're fooling around with your friends, please don't hold any of these type of chokeholds. Oh, oh! I think about the blood being splattered all around. Is it infectious or not? We think about this in the hospital where somebody has a bloodborne pathogen. He's wearing a mask, so there's some sort of aerosolization of this. Same thing with the hospital. We're wearing different types of devices to prevent any droplets of infection getting into us. Barehanded, you're punching somebody in the face. It's actually a really bad idea. You're gonna potentially fracture your own hand. Boxer's fracture is typically a fracture of your fourth or fifth metacarpal. It snaps and angulates really badly. You'll be in a cast for a while, and sometimes you might need a pin if there's too much angulation. Sometimes you see in these games where somebody gets shot once and they die. That happens. Sometimes people can get shot 10 times and they still survive. It just all depends on where they get shot. And literally this is something that we do see at the hospital. Oh, with these type of injuries, you have typically a small hole and then a big hole on an exit wound. So a lot of times we'll see broken skull in the back with some brain matter coming out. Brain matter is typically like a grayish white in color. Kind of soft actually, softer than you think.
Don't do anything stupid.
Oh, oh, oh man. What are you thinking? Like shooting somebody that close to you? You just perforate your eardrums. You have a ringing in your ears all the time. That's called tinnitus. It also causes distortion of balance because the balance center of your brain has to do with your vestibular nerve in your ear. A lot of fist fighting. Oh. This is intense.
Intense.
Hitting their face on the rail, you're gonna cause potential fracture, laceration. You're also concerned about whiplash injury where there's a cervical spine injury where the body's going down and the head kind of snaps back.
Look, all right, just hear me out on this. I gotta-
Oh!
Stop!
Ugh. You see the guy, he took a foot to the nose and he's got a laceration to the bridge of the nose there. This is your nasal bone right here, this top piece. It could fracture pretty easy. I've had people come in where it's like literally to the side and you have to snap it back over if it's really deformed. He's got his arm in a funky position. He's probably doing some rotational forces to it. And if you continue to rotate, it's just gonna cause a lot of discomfort on the shoulder itself. And it can cause a rotator cuff injury as well as potentially dislocate if you have enough force in a different direction.
Excuse me.
I didn't have much of a choice. I owed someone.
Just give me a couple.
Oh! I want to know, did he just break the elbow? Holding down the force on the humerus, does he pull up on the radius in the ulna and snap it back and either fracture or dislocate? A lot of times you would think that you'd snap off the olecranon. Typically, that hurts a lot.
That's gotta hurt.
Oh! Oh! With using that type of either polymer or metal, you're gonna cause probably some potential fractures. I don't know if anybody's hit this bone here in the back, your mastoid. It hurts a lot. Underneath that is a styloid process. It can cause a lot of pain too. It's actually one of those pressure point areas to cause pain. It's raining. All I can think about is trench foot that you could potentially get. Soggy, wet, typically your feet where they don't heal, and then it's called like wet gangrene. Basically you can get where like the tissue starts to rot. Oh! Always have to make sure that you get dry clothes on. You can also cause a lot of chafing in certain areas and cause chronic wounds. We see that in the emergency department when somebody comes in with rotting tissue. It smells so bad. But if you use sodium bicarb, it actually neutralizes the smell so everybody can tolerate it. Oh, wow. A blade right to the lateral aspect of the leg above the knee. Mostly muscle there. Not any major blood vessels are sitting right there on the side. They're on the back side of that. Now it can cause a lot of pain. And then if you sever the tendon and the muscles, obviously the leg's not gonna work as well as it should. When somebody first passes away, they're gonna be potentially just dead weight. They're actually really, really heavy. Then over time, rigor mortis is gonna set in and it's gonna be stiffening of the body because you have pooling of fluids that make tissue really tense and really hard to move.
Marlene set us up?
Marlene!
Why the hell are we smuggling an infected girl?
I'm not infected.
No?
Look at this.
I don't care how you got infected.
We see people who come into the emergency department who are actually bit by another human, and you can see bite marks like that. We definitely give antibiotics, we clean it out as best we can, and we actually leave the wounds open because if we seal it shut with sutures, it's actually gonna seal the infection inside the wounds. This was good, I really enjoyed it. If you guys enjoyed it, let me know. Let me know what parts I should check out, if there's any other scenes that you'd want me to talk about. And as always, make sure that you check out this playlist right here, and make sure you subscribe, turn those bell notifications on, and hit that like button for me. Thank you so much for watching and stay healthy, my friends.